everything fine. So everything's fine, everything's recording. Okay, no worries.
Okay, we'll see you soon.
Indeed.
2 hours.
About 2 hours? I'll race that. Indeed. See how we go. No worries, that's it. Alright, weather will put. So this is where we have to start the tea trees now, guys. It's not actually the start of the tea trees at all. But the farmer who owns the land at the start of the tea trees doesn't really like us walking through his orchard to get to the river, so we have to come up here now, which is the closest public river access to the start of the tea trees. Watch all this submerged stuff. So we've got about 0.6 on the tea trees gauge today. 0.6 is actually pretty good, but after talking to couple of paddlers down at Possults just now before we when I was dropping off the car at the finish, they told me that it's pretty low, and there's a section of day two tea trees, which if you look up day two tea trees video from a couple of years ago, day two start video from a couple of years ago, you'll see that the river is blocked and we had to carry the boats over an island to get out and get back to the water. He says that that's what the case is right now, so I'm really hoping that that's not it and that we can bash through somewhere, but worst comes to worst, gonna have to get out and carry over an island. Only a small one, like maybe that's a bit higher than that one there, but similar to that one over there, with water on the other side, however. So that's something to look forward to. That's pretty much the last thing on the day today, the last thing on the paddle today. That's just above Possults Ford, where we're finishing today's paddle. Today we're paddling from the Wetherall Park to Possults Ford, which includes all of the tea trees section of the Avon descent. So this will be a good one at, as I said, 0.6 meters of water. So should be able to see a good bit of the channels that exist this year. Have had a few floods up to 2.5 meters, so the tea trees might be washed out and changed from years gone by, and that's why these paddlers telling me it's blocked is quite believable, because it's, well, 0.6 usually means that there'll be plenty of water to get through day two tea trees. And there are channels in day two tea trees. If you have watched those videos now, you'll see that there's a channel on the right, which is usually blocked about halfway down, or has many tree logs and trunks come across it. And generally, you don't want to be in that channel past halfway, past about 300 meters down. So you generally start off on the right and then cut to the left, or go to the left if you can get through, but it's a bit tree friendly on the left. So start on the right, cut to the left, and then you want to be in that middle channel for a little while, and then you cut back to the right again after the blockage, but it's after a ford, so it gets open for a little bit, and then you cut right, and you pretty much stay right. Look at this shallow little section, eh? Interesting. Let's see if we want to run aground here. Yeah, then you cut to the right, and you pretty much stay right for all of the tea trees. Is the general rule, right is right. So if you come to a decision and you see water going to the left and to the right, and they both look about as good as each other, 99% of the time you want to take that right channel. It happens to be the correct way. No particular rhyme or reason to it. Just realized that over the years, that the right channel is generally the right one. Besides at the beginning there, where I've just talked about, where you start on the right and then it becomes blocked or full of trees, you might say, and the left is also a shorter route from that point. So I'm going to try and cut across here. This is a sandbar filled pool, and if you look over to the left there, you see it gets very nice and shallow. So what that tells me is the water is not taking the corner and going around the outside here. So in low years, you have to look out for these sandbar pools and navigate your way to the deepest sections. And you will run aground if you don't. So like on the left here, you will run aground. It's only a couple of inches deep. And very hard to see as you can see. Yeah, call them zigzag pools. Follow the water. Here we are in a bit of fake tea trees. So the reason the tea trees begin at the orchard, which is still coming up, is that in the 60s, I believe, the river was cleared of all of the tea trees down to the orchard, and then it was abruptly halted. And I don't quite know why, but probably environmental reasons, good reason to stop. And thus, the tea tree section of the river remains, and this section we're in right now is pretty clear and open. And the whole section from Northam, in fact, they started clearing, I believe, from Northam to 2J, and then kept clearing from 2J, and then stopped pretty soon after 2J, which is where we are, where the orchard is. So Northam to 2J is pretty open and clear, and has the extracts weir on it for industry, so you can imagine that they wanted that section nice and clear for water capture, and for that dam to not get filled with logs and trees and crud, which is definitely what happens if you leave tea trees in the river. Or trees in general, I guess. Whew. All right. These are the little sprint pools. Tea trees are dotted with these pools, which are natural as well as man-made, so this one's probably been cleared years ago, but pools further down seem to be natural. Also seems to be plenty of water today. Channel wisely. Alright. This is still not true tea trees. Well, I mean it is honestly, but still not at the orchard, which is the official beginning of the tea trees. Probably want to go middle there. Okay, that's pretty shallow though. This will be fun. good practice. For half an hour's time. Yeah, cut those corners. Trees generally are on the outside of corners. So you want to cut those corners and take the inside line. If you're a racing driver, you'll know about hitting those apexes. You want to cut those apexes with the boat. And let the water spin you around as much as possible, but be ready for that water to spin you around, of course. And you saw me there doing a rudder stroke. So I actually got spun around too much. And I didn't want to spin out and go backwards, so I ruddered on the left. Of course, to turn the corner, you would rudder on the right to turn right. But remember to keep your speed. The last thing you want to do is stay stationary in the water and let the water carry you down, because then you have no directional control in the water and worse, stability. Your stability is compromised. Another little shallow pool here. See the water right there. The ground. Dirt. And you can see my boat loves to go at angles at the first opportunity. Zoom. It's gonna push me that way. Yeah. Little side boils are useful to push you where you want to be pushed. They'll usually push you off the banks. But they are rushing past. It's shallow, but it's passable. It's fine. This pool, memory is the same, and it hasn't changed. Left-hand bank, the deepest water. Little trick. In really low years, you find that by the riverbank is the deepest water when it's really low. As the sandbars start to appear in the middle, the water finds those channels, which are generally deepest by the bank. Of course, the trees live by the bank, so sometimes you've got to go quite close to the trees on the bank, which of course make it more exciting. Birds in front. Oh yeah, and the boat's dry. So the patch has worked. And my boat no longer leaks. That is good. This is good, yeah. pool might be the orchard. Coming up. Silly spoondles, stay on your log. Don't follow the rest of those sheep down the river. Hey, smart birds. Look at you guys. Hey, somebody doesn't have to keep flying down the river today. Poor little water fruits. Looks like the orchard to me. Looks a bit different now. Well, it's the TiTrees, I think. 2.83 km in. Yeah, I used to go there. Not today. Probably want to go over there. Day 2 TiTrees that we were talking about, cutting left and cutting those directions. And this is day 1, which you do want to stay right generally as well. This first section is a bit of every man for themselves, where the right hand side is usually quite twisty and turny, and the left hand side is kind of open like this, but it suddenly get shallow and you have to get to the right. So we're going to look for a window to the right hand side and take it as soon as we can. Probably should have taken some of those routes up the upstream there from us, but we decided today we're going to try this right hand side. Ooh, there's a nice, it's not really an obstacle, is it? Just a grassy bank that the water was flowing over. So there's the shallow middle channel. Don't take the middle channel. It's pretty obvious today. Now we're in the middle channel, or left hand channel of the river, which is merged with the middle. And we need to get to the right hand channel at the earliest convenience. That water going under the trees and get out of that water flow as soon as you can, unless you want to go under the tree, which you're allowed to do, of course, but I don't recommend. This is where we're going to drag back right. And we're going to get to the right hand side of that tree there in the river. This is the first of the fords. That's pretty easy. Nice log there to watch out for. Alright, now we're in the correct channel for the whole rest of the tea trees. Let's race down here and stay right at every opportunity. Except for the start of day two, where I mentioned earlier. Which we'll talk about when we get to it. About an hour away. Channel over there, the left of the island, and it's about to get dry. And people over there are going to wish they were over here. Some sand on my knee, making a nice little grit inside the boat when I was pressing up against it. It is now resolved. See that other channel come in a moment here. There's not a lot of water in it. When in doubt, take that right hand channel. Hey, look, it's the correct way. What a surprise! A correct way. Wow, come on, water pressure. Water is not very strong today. In fact, it's not strong enough to push you around some obstacles you might think it would. That's where Deucey thinks you should go. Yeah, mate. Don't grab things if you're moving faster than walking speed. Grabbing things is bad unless you're pretty much stopped or plan to be stationary. Even then, usually it's better to let the thing bounce off your boat. Be prepared for it bouncing off your boat, like I've explained in a video a couple of years ago. Nice little obstacle here. Cut the corner, remember, even if you ground out, hit the bottom. Better than hitting that tree, especially when all the water forces pushing up against the tree. I mean, it's a no-brainer to me that you want to be out of that water force if it is near an obstacle. Basically, if the water is going down the middle of the river and there's no obstacles, you want to be in that water because it's obviously the fastest place to be. If that water is heading to an obstacle and going straight through it or under it, like here, of course you don't want to be in that water. So get out of it as soon as you can. Remembering what fast-moving water will do. It'll suck your boat in, it'll turn your boat around, it'll 80 out. It'll honestly increase speed. Be ready for all those things. Okay, so when in doubt, head to the right. But are we in doubt here? That right channel does look pretty much as good as the left. You want to see how much water is going down each channel, because even if the top looks bad, like the top of this one looks pretty bad here. There was, however, it's pretty rocky there, yeah, there's a rock there. There is, however, a lot of water going down here. So you can be sure that if that obstacle is clearable without hitting a rock like I did, derp, then this way should be passable all the way down, as long as the water doesn't flow out of the channel back into the left one. Now, this is a bony channel at very low water, but 0.6 is not very low water. I see a rock up ahead, I'm just gonna graze the tree instead of hitting that rock. Now, it's water coming into this channel, so we know it's now going to be deeper, or put it another way, more right now. It's definitely more correct. Yep. So there are channels now coming in from the left, which are obviously filling this channel up. And those channels, I have vivid memories, because this is definitely where you want to be from here. And the earlier you want to get, the earlier you can get right, like I did, the better. Remember that decision, left or right? And I chose right simply because it had more water, had just as much water, and hit that rock at the top. Well, that was definitely the right decision, because that middle channel is what came in just back there. And if you could see, it was very, very shallow and bony. And it split up into about the three little sub channels. And I've got a video years ago coming down in the Wizard with Dad's very fast Kevlar boat. And I've got stuck in that channel, trying to come through those little sub channels back into this here right channel. And had to push my way through a couple of logs, and great fun. Definitely not the fastest way. Now, we have two yellow kayaks are coming up behind us, but I hope they don't catch us, because they're starting a fair bit behind us, and I'm hoping we aren't that slow. Har har har. Another shallow pool here. So you can see these pools are all lined with trees and tea trees, small trees and large trees, because they have not been cleared 50, 60 years ago, like the ones above. If you remember the pool where we began at Wetherall Park and came down to the orchard, those pools all had bare banks. The riverbanks had no trees and no bushes on them. So they'd been cleared years ago, and the only remaining vegetation is the river gums, those big trees in the distance there that don't grow in the river. So the river itself stayed bare. This pool should have a giant sandbar in the middle, but I'm not seeing it just yet. So we'll keep our eyes peeled. Looks like that right side might have more water, in fact, but we'll stay left. Pick a side, stick to that side is generally a good rule in shallow water, sandbar filled pools. Now, I'm talking a lot for this video. There goes a train. It's a Indian Pacific. Well, one carriage of Indian Pacific by the look of it. And then cargo. I wonder if they do that nowadays. It's strange. Our trains come all the way from Sydney. these options now at the end of the big pool, and a lot of people will go left here, but, well, left appears blocked, far left is blocked, medium left, centre left, ho-hum, centre-centre, ho-hum, let's go centre-centre. Remember, we have to jag right as soon as possible, because we want to be right, but that right channel is not looking good from up here. So I'm going centre. More water is flowing here, but won't be flowing here for long. We need to get over there, haha. So we're going to do, we're going to be through there, and easiest way through there is through here, unfortunately. So we made a wrong turn there, fellas. We want it to be on the other side of that stuff in the middle, because we are about to run out of water in that channel. So yeah, we want to be through there. That's the correct way. Okay. The reason I'm talking a lot is because this video is going to double as this year's river guide for this section of the river. So I'm hoping to not lead you astray like I just did. So again, we're still not in the right-hand channel, we're in the central right channel, but we want to be in that right channel. Yeah, I know there's water on the left. Oh, okay, so our dumb little move there going upstream, pointless. But that is the channel we want. Yes, okay, so again, left hand side about to end, right hand side bony but correct. Again, wrong way. So this is where you want to come in. Down there, yeah, easy. Okay, easy. So I went right too early again. Alrighty. So start left, head right. Remember that. Smash the tree. Little branches generally can be moved by yourself. Big branches like that one, cannot. If you hit that, you would want to slow right down. Try and miss it, try and duck. If you are not going to miss it, then slow right down and push on it with your hands. Push off. Don't grab the thing. Don't assume you're going to be able to get grabbing on it, because half of these things are dead and will break off. And the other half are very strong and don't move and will cause you to flip over if the water is moving you at any speed. This is the correct channel now. Saying stuff like that. So yeah, we can get through here. Yeah. Interesting, that's a good one. See? Too strong. A lot of nice obstacles here. In that right hand channel now, it's going to stay on the right. Yeah, not there. Dunk. Even further right, maybe. Okay, so, do you think we're on the right-hand bank? I don't. think we're in the middle, but this is the correct way. So that left hand side is too shallow. Six. Not a bad speed. Alright. What do you reckon? I reckon right side. I reckon this is dumb. I reckon this might be the wrong choice. I'm gonna stick to my guns. That guy wouldn't move. No. Of sorts. There's enough space here. Crunch. Yeah, you can go down there, easy way. Yeah, to the right there would have been the easy way. Had a little bit of a zigzag turn, but put in your rudder stroke, cut those corners, you'll be fine. Prepare early for overheads, duck your head, keep your paddle down with the front blade on top of your boat, where you can see it and it doesn't get stuck in anything. Rear blade, really doesn't matter, it's going to get pulled in, and make sure your front blade is touching the front of your boat. And in my case, I want to have that back blade ready to push on the water so I can control the boat if I need to. Because my boat does not go straight ahead for very long without input from me. It doesn't have a rudder and it just relies on paddling and leaning to turn the boat. Leaning is very effective in fact and doesn't slow you down. Or cause you to have to break your rhythm of paddling, which is very useful. Much more efficient turning. Alright, some dead stuff there on the left. And a big sandbar. Great. So this is the shallow side of the pool now, and we should have cut over at some point into the deep side, but we missed it. Could have stayed over to that bank, but that island in the middle was becoming an island. I'm going to stick to my trusty left-hand side of the river and see how much water is there. Oh, look at that. Quite a lot. Excellent. I believe this is the long pool in the middle of the tea trees. The pool above Jimpity. Your boat, drink your drink, eat your food, maybe stop and have a poo. Because you still have plenty more to go. So there's not really enough water going down that right side to justify. Although, you know, right is right. Yeah, that right side is possible. I think we're going to get pushed into the right now anyway. So, left hand. Definitely not left, of course. Yeehaw! See the eddy? Trying to spin me around. Would not have been a good time. Yeah, no water there today. Eesh. Alright, now the right gets progressively more and more bony, and at 0.5, thought you could get through. The little tiny chute we're going to have to take down the left now, but I guarantee it is the nicest way through today. Yep, okay. Oh, easy. Nice. Thank you. a problem here. A bit higher water. And maybe it's there Deucey thinks you go. Cut that right hand side, yeah. I mean, you could do it, Deucey, with your feet. Nice. See, that's what you would avoid if you went over there, but I like this part. Yeehaw! This is a long pull, I think. Pull above the pull above gendering. Alright. Yeesh. Yeah, pick your side. Deep here. Thank you. maybe that pool also right is right. Looks like more water on this side. See? To come through there, I think. And then that log on the left there was higher and more challenging. And we would go on the left. Now we come through here. Thank you. dead log in it. That's a killer. That's a killer. Be careful here, boys and girls. Cut that corner. Cut that corner a lot. Because that, right now, is a wackadoodle. That would get you. That would get you. And that's the alternative. It actually looks like it's not too bad today. Okay. So, maybe the center channel above here. We'll review the video and see if it's a goer above there. Definitely don't want to lead people down that right-hand side into that little overhanging loggy bit. That water was powerfully pushing you into the log, and there were rocks on the right that were obviously going to be out of the water soon if the water drops. So you couldn't cut that corner as much as I did if it was any lower. I cut, and I still hit the rocks, but I managed to keep it straight, which is difficult. Don't do that if you can avoid it. Something. K's in the first hour. Not bad. Not bad. That's a good one. Made a driftwood. So, this is where I head right, and other people go, oh, I don't know about that, blah, 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 blah. Probably want to be in that extreme right channel over there. This one's pretty shallow. We'll make it though. Or will be. Crunch, crunch. Probably would be fine either way. I prefer the right there. I know it. Know the route. I think we're in the pool above Jimpening now. Doesn't look like the whole river, does it? Not a lot of water movement. This pool reminds me of pool above Jimpening vibes. This pool gives me pool above Jimpening vibes, in fact. Thanks, Kurt. quite to see just yet. Pretty sure it's still coming. Just here. Okay, well, gotta stick by our saying, right? Right is right. The correct way again. Right. Right saves the day once more. Space. There is a hut. Don't know which one you are. Probably 5 km from Cobblers. Somewhere near Cobblers. It should be over here. He's there. Take that earliest window. to fix a mistake. Generally, things will get harder and harder to fix as you get further downstream, like that area. And obviously you can't, well you can, but can't reverse time to go back and just take the channel after the fact, can you? Unless you go back upstream like I do. It's a waste of time. And of money. See, don't grab that stuff. Don't whack it with your paddle. Make sure your paddle doesn't get stuck in it, of course. Obstacle. So, if you're not au fait with this, take your time. It's the only time that you should touch stuff. And you're bumping off it and going at walking pace. Oh, nice. Yeehaw! Now, do we go right? No, we don't. This must be the pool above in Jupiter now. Yeah. certainly goes on and on, doesn't it? The boat doesn't leak anymore. Jimbody. Get this wrong all the time. remember, right is the right way. We missed jumping. Oh well. Leatherheads rapids, the only rapids in the TiTrees. And to do leatherheads, you take the extreme right again. Woof. Hey, God. Another freight train. Well, another train. Okay. So this is Cobbler's Pool. Finish of day one. Right under this cable here. So right now. Exactly 14.54 kilometers from Wetherall Park. And you can see people are already camping here. In anticipation of the race in about 30 days, 35 days, caravanning and whatnot. Now off on day two. Alright. Only like 3Ks or something. Something like that. Apparently a portage. I don't believe it. Oh. Present this year. It looks pretty open to me. So, what we have to decide is if the left-hand channel has enough water in it, or the center channel has enough water in it, the channel to the left of us. Do we take it, knowing that the guys are saying the right-hand one is blocked? That one is open. Okay. And then this next little park is where we usually go across and get into it. So we'll make the decision just here. Okay, that might be there.
Oh, it's blocked, I can't get under.
Well, that's freaking perfect. Here. Used to. Not today. Alright. So that's not a goal. This is definitely a goal so far. See what they mean further on. was the quote-unquote blockage. Shall see. Not fit, me, Terry. No, not fit. No excuse of having the boat full of water today. Here's where we want to go back right again. I mean, we're just following the flow, of course, but we want to be in that right-hand passage, right-hand channel. Oh, there's a log. Yeah. It's a bendy one. One that is not stuck in the ground. Channels where the water is going where you want to go. Straight down the middle. Now, we got to get right, I believe, through there. Right there, there's a gap. Ooh, good gap. There's a channel. Interesting, interesting. So we're going to go through there. Is there any way through there? We're going to go further upstream. Could one get into there from above? No is the answer. Thank you. through here. Thank you.
not turning now.
Possults forward. Official end of the TiTrees. Official start of the valley. And all the rapids. Of which are a bit rocky today. So we're just going to do Possults. And get out just below there. Just below here. Because... single rock in that location that I can see or hit. We're at a nice big flat rock to get out there. We won't do super shoot today. We'll do it in the valley run next time. Nice. Check the water level. It's very shallow. Alrighty. We're done, everybody. Thanks for watching. Bye. Alright, well, we're gonna cut this video. I'm gonna